All right, let's go for another one here. Nope, don't focus on Obama, focus on me.
So I'm going to go over a conversation that I've had several times in my life, and the conclusion of this video should have you understanding pretty well whether or not you want to start reading classic sci-fi or not. This conversation that I've had probably between 10 to 15 times in my life, more recently than not, goes along these lines. Hey, I'm interested in classic sci-fi. Where do you recommend I get started? Follow-up question I will always throw at them is, okay, what science fiction-y things have you already had experience with? Star Trek, Battlestar Galactica, did you like them? If there's no sci-fi experience whatsoever, what do you typically like in your reading? Do you like character-driven, plot-driven, world-building? What are you really looking for here? And of course, I get some very diverse answers, the worst being, I've never really read much before, and the best being like, well, I've read The Martian, which is modern sci-fi, but I'm really kind of looking to go more classic. And then I'll go, okay, did you like whatever they told me they read? Let's go with The Martian for this one. And they'll say, yes, great. That's pretty character-based, and it has some great sci-fi elements to it. It's kind of a survival story. And then I'll push them into some recommendations based off of their liking of this one or a couple stories, whatever they told me. It goes well. What doesn't go well is usually the follow-up. The follow-up is usually a call or text or a brief conversation along the lines of, hey, this sucks. This is unlike any other thing I've read. Why did you recommend I read this? It's just boring and not a very interesting narrative. And that's my fault. I should have done something different there. I should explain what classic sci-fi is, how it differs greatly from its modern counterpart, and really help people understand whether or not they should get into it. Now, this is probably already sounding very pretentious, and I do not want that to be the case. Classic sci-fi is not inherently better than any genre, but it is massively different than most other genres out there because its focus is just outside of what most fiction will focus on. Now, modern sci-fi, or as it's often referred to, sci-fantasy, really barely shows a reflection of its roots. It's much more influenced by modern fantasy than its classic sci-fi origins. That's just true. And again, that is not inherently better or worse, but it does mean the genre of the classic sci-fi is dying out. Now, let me stop wasting your time and go ahead and explain what classic sci-fi really is. Classic sci-fi, most of the time, explores an idea. It does have character, typically. It does have some kind of development or arc. There is some form of plot, but that is not the focus. The focus of classic science fiction, especially in writing and in movies as well, was exploring a concept or a consequence of an introduced element to us as a society. You could really boil this down to a what if. What if humans didn't control their evolution? This is something that is explored in Childhood's End. Not to spoil things very heavily, but the main conflict of the book is humanity kind of being guided and understanding that their end game, their next step, is an inevitability. It's outside of our control. There's nothing we can do. This next step is coming. There are characters, of course, and there is a plot and some form of narrative structure that does come along these lines, but that is not the focus of the story. Classic sci-fi is about what ifs at its core. There are some people who legitimately balk at the idea of calling even Star Wars science fiction. They ask, where's the science? Yes, there's spaceships and things, but they by no means are the focus. They're never explained. You can take them away and the story would not be changed that much. Take away the Death Star and a bunch of TIE fighters, replace it with a train and some horses, and you got essentially the same setting. I kind of disagree and agree with this sentiment. I find it a little bit annoying as genres evolve, and science fiction is not the genre it once was. Saying these things are not science fiction, well, maybe technically accurate in some way. You need to adapt to the modern times, and Star Wars is what we, by now our standards, call science fiction. And this is coming from someone who loves Star Wars. I'm not trying to cheapen Star Wars. There are many names that are brought up when modern sci-fi is being talked about. Heinlein, Arthur C. Clarke, Ray Bradbury, and most of the time, the undisputed king is Isaac Asimov. He wrote some of the most influential science fiction stories of all time, including The Laws of Robotics, you hear name dropped probably in every movie that has robots in it, period. Something that's important to note about a lot of these guys who wrote classic sci-fi back in the day, they were academics. These were people who were interested in actual science and philosophy, and that influenced their writing in huge ways. So I have said all of this just so I can package this nice little point and everyone can have a firm understanding of where I'm coming from when I say this. Do not expect typical story beats or character development or things like that when you jump into a classic sci-fi story. All you should expect to do is explore a what-if scenario from a very academic perspective. And if you're going in expecting something along the lines of Star Wars, can really subvert your expectations in a bad, harsh way. But that does not mean you cannot enjoy the genre. My recommendation for anyone who is still interested after understanding where classic sci-fi is coming from, what the purpose is, and who wrote it, is to go with maybe some bridge stories. Stories that fall between the modern standard of sci-fi and the classic standard of sci-fi. I find the prime example of this to be the Bobverse series. It does explore a central idea: what if someone had the ability to explore all the cosmos and could reduplicate themselves infinitely? Very interesting concept, but it does have a ton of character bleeding from the pages, and on that end is really falling into modern standards. You're going to have your typical character development and a focus much more heavily on typical storytelling methods. If you liked Bobverse and the idea and concept behind it and the evolution of that idea throughout the story, then I highly recommend you pick up maybe a character-driven classic like Stranger in a Strange Land or Fahrenheit 451. Both excellent classic sci-fi stories. If maybe you want a little bit less of an investment than a full, huge, massive story you have to dive into, Passage Through Tomorrow is a series of short stories by Robert Heinlein, and they are magnificent. Each one kind of dabbles into these ideas and expands on them very quickly, and in a way where you're not gonna be really attached to any characters, but trust me, you'll be fascinated. Or maybe you wanna go just diving into the deep zone, and in that case, the Foundation trilogy is where you should go. And if you wanna just dive into the genre as deeply as possible, Isaac Asimov's Foundation trilogy is arguably the best the genre ever produced, and it is hardcore classic sci-fi, and it is wonderful. But if that is not your taste, that is completely okay. It's absolutely acceptable to just like the typical storytelling around us and dive into the magnificent levels of storytelling that are happening every day. We are in a golden age of media. That is without a doubt true. And you don't have to have this deep knowledge of classic sci-fi. And this is the point I'm really gonna end the video on. Well, it's personally a genre I deeply love and admire. I'm kind of tired of this snobby mentality that classic sci-fi is some form of higher reading for the educated. No, it's not. It's an exploration of idea from one person's perspective, and very often an incredibly biased perspective. These authors also have agendas that are trying to drive home. Stranger in a Strange Land is a great example of that. It might be an agenda I somewhat agree with in certain ways in certain parts of the story, but it's still an agenda. Heinlein was trying to make a point with what he put there, just as all modern authors are trying to. They're telling their stories. These guys just happen to be nerds on my level who wanted to tell a story of a what if scenario. I hope this video was somewhat informative, because one of the most common questions I get every time I mention my really deep love of classic sci-fi is, how should I get into it? And the path I laid out is honestly the best one I think you could do. Try Bobverse or maybe The Martian from the modern perspective, and if you like the elements of that story that clearly came from its ancestors, go ahead and explore those as well with maybe some more character-driven pieces. Just to relist them again, I think Stranger in a Strange Land and Fahrenheit 451 are two branches off the same tree that are a wonderful introduction to the genre. And after that, maybe go a little more hardcore with A Passage Through Time, the Foundation trilogy, or one that's deeply, deeply connected to my heart, Childhood's End. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe if you have not already. Hit the Patreon if you want to support what I do here. And have a good one, y'all. Peace. Hey, no. No.